And even for my children, it's something that I'm worried about. I mean, things have changed a hell of a lot.
Drastically, right?
Yeah. A hell of a lot. But there are still, you know, the bad apple occasionally. True. Sam's insecurity.
Two things. In two phases of my life. When I was young, I actually used to really shake in front of people. Yeah, you know, like when I, for example, when I was in school, right? We had this thing where it was like a huge register and everybody had to like come sign right next to their names. And just waiting for that, I was like, I was super anxious. And once my name is called, I'm going to sign. Like, I'm just like shaking for everybody. My teacher's like, do you drink? Like, did you drink the night before?
Yeah, that's
you,
like
did you shake like a lot? Yeah, it's like
noticeably?
Yeah, it was like crazy. This. Like my hands would like go like crazy.
Oh.
You know, and
that just happens to me normally. Like I get the shakes.
Yeah, here's for the no thing. Reason. I thought I was the only person that had that. Till I met friends like, I shake all the time. Like when I hold a like say an object for like
so
let's
it wasn't
say,
nerves.
It wasn't nerves. So like even till now when I do this, like my hands will shake a little.
Yeah,
bit.
Yeah, I get that.
Yeah, like I have that, and that used to like really bother me, dude.
I don't want to look.
Yeah, like
it's my shit shaking. It's my shit shaking. As he sticks his hand in his
armpit. Yeah. If it's like, gonna shake down here, baby.
Yeah. Shake, señora. Yeah, like this is a shake, and also. Like a lot of female friends that I had, they used to laugh at me that I had huge hands. Like, oh my gosh, like you're only 12 and your hands like this huge. They used to laugh at me. And I was like very veiny. Like I was
yeah,
really
those
vain.
Those are things that are cool.
Yeah. I did not know that. I only realized they were cool when I got to Korea.
I wish I was veiny. Whenever I need to get an injection at the doctor and take blood, they're like, oh yeah. Shit, didn't work. Didn't work again.
Yeah.
Like a pin cushion. They inject me like 5 or 6 times to get some blood.
Yeah. But that is the crazy thing. Like these are things that I really hated about myself growing up. Like I would literally try and keep my arm in a position where you couldn't see my veins.
Oh, veins are sexy.
That's
though.
Crazy.
Because like, I hated them. Cool. And then I come to Korea and like, oh my gosh, you have some nice, big, sexy hands. I'm like, say what? Nah.
Well, Kawhi Leonard has made big hands.
You know the call, right?
Yeah.
And like, you have, oh, your veins are popping. Like, oh my gosh, that's sexy. And to my head, I was like, what the hell? These are things that I grew up being like super, super insecure about. And I'm here and people are looking at me like, oh, that is cool. So that was like really crazy for me.
Yeah.
The fact that people look at things really differently. Wow. Now you go to the hospital, they want to draw blood. You're like, don't worry about it. just put in the needle and you're good. Right? So
pick a vein.
So everyone has to have an insecurity. When you're as handsome as Sam, they're having big hands and muscly muscle veins. But everyone's got
big hands and muscle veins.
muscle veins.
They go hand in hand, don't they?
Yeah. Yeah, but yo, that used to really bother me as a child, man. Like,
that's crazy.
When I met my female friends, I put my hands in my pocket. Or like not try to shake them.
Wow. Really?
Yep, bro. Wow. It was like really bad for me. But like I was good at hiding it. But every time I was at home, I look at my hands. I'm like, damn, man.
It's kind of like being pale. People used to give me shit in the States for like, you need a tan.
Oh, word?
You need a tan. But in Korea, people are like, they like the pale skin.
Right. I always thought you were very pale though. But part of that being but
it's a Western thing.
But that's also your lifestyle. You spend
indoors,
a lot more time indoors.
I can't get it. I turn red and then I go back to lack of melatonin. What is it called?
Melanin.
Are you you're not albino.
Yeah, I don't know, dude. But I feel less insecure about it in Korea, I guess. Yeah. You know?
Is it
People in America are all about tans, man.
No, but
is it
being in Korea or is it because you've become older?
I don't know, man.
More
like
more comfortable.
I used
yourself?
To hate
you're comfortable
being
in
pale.
Your skin.
Well, all my family have like a nice tan, man. They're all Latinos, but I'm the only pale
one. Yeah, but
one.
Here, Hyung, like the point that you mentioned, like being comfortable in your skin also comes with the kind of environment that you're in, right?
Absolutely.
Because if you are in a place where everybody's like getting at you for the thing that you really hate the most, you're not going to get up one day and be like, I'm super comfortable with this. Like it never happens like that.
Yeah, but I think it's also, it is when you get older as well. It's one of the things that changes.
Like
you
don't care
of
more.
Start
don't
giving
care.
Less
yeah,
of a
like
fuck.
You don't care, right? Yeah.
Like this times where I'm just like,
yeah, you're right. Yeah,
I'm like, I probably shouldn't do this, but I don't care. I'm going to take my t-shirt off and boom. Yeah. Like people are like, oh shit. And I'm like, okay, I'm comfortable in my skin.
Boy, he
like
thick.
Burnt crush.
Yeah.
I'm
like, oh my God.
It doesn't
crust.
It shouldn't matter what other people think, as long as you're comfortable.
True.
And, like I think insecurities become less of an issue the older you get.
Yeah, right? That's true.
Like even for me, like getting on stage is something I still have issues with, but it's kind of like you're less concerned with how people think of you?
Yeah, because the older you get, here's the thing. The older you get, the more secure you are in your body. So that insecurity, the in drops, and you just have security. So you don't have to worry about all those things anymore.
Do you worry about having, if you were talking about how maybe you wanted to have kids here.
Yeah.
Do you worry about raising Black kids in Korea?
Yes. That's something that I do think about a lot, you know, because I have friends who are married to Koreans here and they have, you know, mixed race babies, and they complain about the fact that every time they send their kids to school, the kids, like, you know, will laugh at them and be like, oh my gosh, look at your hair or look at your skin.
Yeah,
you know,
they look
like, and they like it, it's hard. It's not easy, you know, so I cannot help but think about that.
No, yeah. Your kids are, Samuel Chidi's my dad.
Yeah, my dad can beat your dad. Yeah. Like, who's your dad? And they're like, Samuel Chidi. And
there's a bus flying by right now. I'll show you who my dad is.
You don't know my dad? Look at that bus. Yeah. Speak now.
Let me take you on a walk to Dunkin' Donuts. His face is on his face is above a fucking Frappuccino.
I tell you what, but that's something for me as well. Like, I'm having kids that, my kids being half Korean, it's like, for so long, you've seen it, that it's been ingrained in society here, right, being a homogenous society. Yeah. And even for my children, it's something that I'm worried about. I mean, things have changed a hell of a lot.
Drastically, right.
Yeah. A hell of a lot. But there is still, you know, the bad apple occasionally. Mm-hmm. And it only takes one person to say something.
That's true.
And, you know, you don't want children having to go through that kind of emotional problem from an early age in life.
Yeah.
And, you know, you have a saying here in Korea, you know, you have to hammer in the nail that sticks out, which is essentially a commentary on individualism, because it is a society where everything is so, you know, community-based. Right, yep. It's a collective society. And if you stand out from the crowd because of, you know, being from a multicultural family as a child, that's something that is always going to be in the back of your parents' mind, and something they're concerned about. Hope you enjoyed the clip. If you did, listen to the full episode on Apple Podcasts or Spotify.
And make sure to subscribe to this channel, Dive Studios, and put those notifications on. Hit that bell. Boop, boop, boop.